The scope of this video is to present the new concept of the model browser in ANSA from the aspect of crash and safety analysis and describe the functionality and the latest developments of ANSA in crash and safety, as well as the adaptation of the already existing tools inside ANSA to the new model browser concept. A virtual model that is specifically studied for crash analysis has many model variants. These include options such as a vehicle with a sunroof or no sunroof, a small versus a large engine size, an all-wheel drive versus a two-wheel drive, and so on. In addition, for the crash analysis there are a lot of protocols and legal requirements. The high number of those leads to numerous load cases that require to be analyzed using data such as dummies, barriers, and impactors. If the model variants and the various load cases are combined, a plethora of simulation runs needs to be generated for a complete analysis. Taking the aforementioned into consideration, the characteristics of a system that would be able to handle them successfully are described. A successful system would allow the user to work seamlessly either as a single unit or as a member of a team. The system should also offer the ability to either work locally or through a server. It should be available and easily operated not only in complicated projects, but in regular, everyday tasks as well. The model and load case data should be easily transferable and reusable in other projects. Finally, the workflow should be solver agnostic, meaning that the user should only have regard about the engineering data rather than the file output in terms of solver keywords. BETA introduced a new system in order to combine all the previously mentioned characteristics. The simulation run architecture can be divided into two major categories from a data perspective: the simulation model and the load case data. The lowest levels of the model data are the parts and the connections. These will be assembled into subsystems and the combination of those becomes a model variant. On the contrary, load case data are library data usually expected to be read-only files. The steps that have to be followed from a process perspective are the assembly of the subsystems and the application of the load case data in the simulation model in order to be able to have a complete simulation run that is going to be input in a solver. Let's dive a little bit deeper in terms of data and process organization. What is a subsystem? A subsystem is a single sub-assembly of the model. This, for example, can be a door, a front or rear axis, a seat, and so on. For ANSA, this could be either an ANSA database or an include file. If we focus in one specific subsystem, for example the body in white, we can see that it consists of parts that have to be meshed and then assembled together. In ANSA, the tool that offers us the ability to handle the subsystems is the model browser. For example, in the body in white subsystem, the model browser allows a discretization of the available data. The user can examine just the geometry and the mesh, and view the connections that connect the internal parts of the subsystem. Selection of interface entities, such as contacts, or model setup entities, such as time history nodes, are also available. The next level of the model data structure is the simulation model. This essentially is the model variant to be solved. In the model browser, there's a dedicated tab for the simulation models where the user can view all the subsystems, the combination of which form the model variant. Information of the target IDs or the transformations is available. For example, for a specific subsystem, the user can view the range of IDs that it occupies in a specific simulation model. Moreover, by using the model browser, one can view the connectors that connect one subsystem to the other. Furthermore, through the tool you can access the corresponding entities where you can take first level actions such as applying them. In addition, model setup entities such as cross sections can be handled and manipulated through the model browser. The next required step in the pre-processing stage is the load case setup. At this level of process, data such as dummies and barriers need to be handled. The table view in the model browser is a view mode where all the available load case items are listed. By just activating a flag button, one can include a library item in a load case. The set of attributes for each load case, such as target IDs and positioning data, can be defined. A list of all the saved positions for a seat or a dummy can be loaded and the user is able to select one among the available options. Once this is completed, the next step is the simulation run setup. As the different simulation models are defined and the load case data have been set up, what is now required is a cookbook in order to join and connect everything together and proceed to a ready-to-solve output. Through using the table view in the model browser, all the desired simulation runs are accessible, and by using the check flag, one can choose the desired model variants and load case scenarios that are available to define a new simulation run. The files,
do not even have to be loaded in ANSA, as a table viewer can work as an editor in order to build the desired simulation runs.
By just using the references and accessing the context menu, the newly defined simulation run can be output. Moving to the available system actions and usability, ANSA is able to save and handle metadata. What are metadata? Metadata are data that provide information for other data.
Now, in a complex simulation model, let's focus on a specific subsystem, the seat.
For this specific simulation run, there are some characteristics of the seat which are related to the simulation scenario. For instance, the position of the seat in the vehicle, information of how the seat is connected to the vehicle, as well as the range of IDs that are occupied in the simulation run. ANSA identifies that information and saves it as metadata.
This results in having the subsystem as a self-contained file. The subsystem can now be used in different model variants by just using different range IDs and different positions for the seat.
Metadata are essentially the information that characterize the existence of a subsystem in the solution of a simulation run for each model variant. As in a crash analysis, various parameters are changing. The advantage of having self-contained subsystems is that the user is able to fetch only the entities that are needed to work on
for the current process. Having self-contained files offers the ability for a team to work in parallel, avoiding errors. Different actions like dummy and barrier positioning can be applied simultaneously by the members of the team, as the data are different and there is no need for the users to interfere with the rest of the model or load case data.
While working inside ANSA, the model can be easily set up in order to be solved using different solvers.
In ANSA, during the workflow process, one can apply actions such as positioning and numbering to specific entities,
which will be, as mentioned before, solver agnostic, taking into consideration only the necessary engineering data, leaving ANSA to work in the background in order to output the respective keywords for each solver. A very important aspect of this process is related to where the data are saved. All the data, from their lowest levels, for instance, parts and connections, to various subassemblies and load cases, up to complete simulation run, can be saved either locally or in a server, thus allowing the user to work as a single unit or as a member of a team. Now, let's focus on some ANSA crash tools. The benefits of using ANSA for a crash analysis is the ability to use various tools and assistance for contacts, constrained nodal rigid bodies, constrained joints, coordinate systems, and cross sections. The advantage is the ability to only consider the engineering data of the analysis and through wizard-like functionalities to easily create the desired entities. ANSA offers a complete suite for a crash and safety analysis. Numbering capabilities, added mass calculations, mass scaling for crash solvers, transformation keywords handling, boundary conditions and loads, auxiliary items such as time history nodes, handling of encryptions,
a complete package of templatized checks,
report tools, results mapping from passing results from another analysis as initial conditions for a complete different analysis, laminate tool for composite materials, and morphing capabilities.
This complete suite for the crash and safety analyst is fully scriptable by using the Python language.
Regarding the latest developments and their adaptation to the new concept that was presented previously, starting from seats and dummies, there are tools such as the seat positioning and the dummy tool which are able to create and save various positions for the seat and the dummy that can be utilized by the model browser, as a list of the available safety positions can be selected in order to be implemented on a specific simulation run.
This list is available by loading a saved file and allows the assignment of the position of the dummy for each combination of dummies and seats.
There is a tool available in ANSA for removing penetrations between the seat and the dummy by deforming the foams of the seat. This tool has been updated and improved further, enabling the contacts of the entities below the foam to be respected, thus resulting in the under-the-seat cushion elements to deform accordingly. A very advanced tool available through ANSA is the dummy self-depenetration. During the working process of a crash analyst, while moving the dummy, penetration between the various parts that consist a dummy can occur. In case small movements take place and penetrations exist, ANSA offers the ability for those to be depenetrated without the necessity to set up a pre-simulation through a third-party solver. For bigger movements of the dummy and possibly bigger depenetrations, there is a different tool available, the Marionette tool, that sets up a pre-simulation for LS-Dyna.
Regarding the dummy restraining, the seatbelt tool in ANSA offers the ability to have a fast creation of the seatbelt, an easy definition of its geometrical and solver parameters, and a real-time change of the shape of the belt by dragging and dropping it in order to achieve the desired shape, ensuring that no penetration occurs between the dummy and the seatbelt, as the video now demonstrates on the left side of the screen. Moreover, since the dummy and the seat are moved, the seat is automatically adjusted to the new position. Finally, assembly points are being created in the anchor areas in order to be used in the model browser and then during the simulation run.
A new tool is currently under development, featuring a direct and realistic calculation of the seatbelt shape according to a user-defined path. As you can see, the belt can easily pass through difficult openings, offering an easy application in examples such as child seats, where seatbelt implementation is much more complex. The tool that couples all the previous features and functionalities is the safety load kit generator. The tool functionality is based on include files. It offers the ability to treat simultaneously different combinations of seats and dummies. For each combination, dummy and seat positioning is applied. The seat is deformed in order to depenetrate. The seatbelt is reapplied, and bulk transformation keywords are created during output. Through this tool, we collect all the transformation keywords and use them in the model browser in order to completely define the simulation run. Regarding the post-processing stage using META, we offer a toolbar for occupant injury criteria. One can automatically get the occupant injury results and combine simulation and test results, having many variants with up to 4 dummies per variant. Due to the advanced META features, we offer the ability to overlay the results, and there are advanced results handling capabilities available as well. ANSA is fully informed and updated regarding all the available regulations and protocols in the market for pedestrian safety. The tool offers a bulk positioning and a load case creation for all the target points created within ANSA. The output of the tool is fully usable, as one can take the transformation files created by the tool and use them in the model browser. Moving to META, a special toolbar developed for pedestrian safety analysis can treat head form, leg form, upper leg test, and flex ply analysis.
The toolbar offers automatic report generation, but also mapping of values on the model can also take place.
A low-speed impact simulation for regulations EC42 and FMVSS 581 is also available within ANSA. Regarding interior safety, a complete suite of tools dealing with all the available regulations can be used through ANSA. The FMVSS 201U, the ECE R21, the ejection mitigation, and the seat impact.
Similar to the pedestrian tool, bulk positioning and load case creation is available, and the output data through the transformation keywords can be used by the model browser. During the post-processing stage in META, and by taking advantage of a special toolbar for the FMVSS protocol, results can be placed into tables, images and videos can be produced, and the results visualization can take place using annotations and lines.
A brand new feature has been developed for ANSA. By having the geometrical shape and the initial thickness of a part available, and through using reverse engineering methods, the initial geometry from which the part was fabricated can be obtained, as well as data such as the thickness distribution, the thinning percentage, the strain, the equivalent plastic strain, and the forming limit diagram are presented using illustrations and contour plots. To sum up, BETA introduces new terms for data and process organization: subsystem simulation model, load case, and simulation run.
The model browser offers the ability to work either by storing data locally as a single unit or through a server as a member of a team. The various data are self-contained files, allowing data reusability and error-free parallel work.
The output of all existing tools are adapted in order to communicate with the new concept of the model browser. Thank you.